Good afternoon and welcome to Spielberg, and to a circuit that in one form or another has held every Austrian Grand Prix in the championship, except the very first back in 1964. It was at this race that John Watson lost a bet, and his beard, when he took Team Penske's only F1 victory in 1976. If anything, the stakes are even higher today, with 25 points available for victory and a crucial advantage in the championship fight. It's one of the shortest laps on the calendar today then, with 7 rights and just 3 lefts, making up the 10 corners of this high-speed circuit. Turn 2 is barely a corner at all. They'll be flat out through there, a left-hand kink into the uphill braking zone of Turn 3. Turns 1, 3 and 4 are all potential opportunities to overtake. Joining me for the Grand Prix once again is Anthony Davidson. Now I want to ask you about Sebastian Vettel. That was a great win in the last race. Can they keep that momentum going this weekend?
There are never any guarantees in this business, but certainly the performance last time out would have boosted their confidence coming into this one.
With that then, let's run through the grid order. Daniel Ricciardo starts from pole position today, with Charles Leclerc alongside. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Verstappen, Raikkonen, Sebastian Vettel and Grosjean, Perez, Alonso, Bottas and Marcus Ericsson, a McLaren, Magnussen, Esteban Ocon and Hartley, Stroll, Hülkenberg, Pierre Gasly and Lewis Hamilton, Sirotkin and Carlos Sainz starts from the back of the grid. And with lights out just moments away, it's time to go down to the track.
Zdravím vás, já jsem FDC61 a dneska vás vítám u 9. závodu 5. sezóny mé kariéry v F1 2018, kde momentálně jedu za McLaren. A podle době nevýrazný výsledek. Takhle startovat nechci, že se nějak vybourám v prvním kole.
Okay, here we go. I know. Focus now for the rest of the race. Move. ABS is now enabled and will be available to use when you are within 1 second of the car ahead in the DRS zone. Rain is forecast in just over 10 minutes' time. Rain in 10 minutes. Other cars, we can't take too many penalties. Okay, some information on Bottas. They have some kind of mechanical problem. Lost the position. Try to keep focus. Your front wing is damaged.
A další flashback na stejném místě.
Okay, gap ahead is 2.1 seconds. Mind that front wing. It'll need replacing if it takes too much damage. That was a big one. Confirm you're okay, please.
Aggressive down.
Approaching the pit window, you'll be on the ultra softs. Our gap to the car in front is 4.1 seconds. To the car behind is 1.9 seconds. Boxing this lap, give us the best in lap you can. Is now running the super soft tyre. That's the super soft on the car behind. Remember, box this lap. Keep an eye on your distance to the speed limit line as you approach, and make sure you don't speed. Exit. Exit now. Pit strategy complete. See these tyres through to the end now. See some rain. ETA is about 15 minutes. Fernando's in the pits. To the car ahead is 4.0 seconds. Nice work, that brings you up in place. Teammate behind is 2.0 seconds. We have 5 laps of fuel remaining. Front is 2.1 seconds. laps of fuel remaining. Okay, gap ahead is 3.6 seconds. This pace is strong, but be aware your tyres need to go the distance. Some information on Verstappen. They're slowing down. It seems like there's some kind of problem with their car.
Tak co se Maxovi stalo? Tady ho máme.
Our gap to the car in front is 3.6 seconds. Well, that's a disappointing result for sure, but we'll try to bounce back at the next one.
And an incredible win for Force India. A brilliant performance. And I have to wonder, Anthony Davidson, just what set them apart from the competition here.
Well, Crofty, this was won through an abundance of speed and an abundance of skillful overtakes. Inside, outside, cutting underneath, we saw it all today. And it's really nice to see a Grand Prix won in that manner. A race, surely, that will satisfy the purists today, I think.
I can see them on their way out to the podium now. Force India have really come a long, long way in this sport. And what a special race this was to see them earn that top spot.
Budu vám mají být úplně jinde.
And after this round of the World Championship, here's how things look in the driver's table. It's a good result for Kimi Raikkonen, who extends his advantage at the top of the championship. Moving on to the driver of the day then, Anthony Davidson, who would you go for?
Difficult call, but I'd like to say Esteban Ocon. He's just so gifted at getting the most out of his tyres, and he showed that today.
And now let's take a look at the constructors' standings. We saw a dip in form from the championship leaders today. Their lead has taken a significant blow. Meanwhile, good work from Force India this weekend, who pushed themselves further up the order. That's it for today's Grand Prix, and from Ant and I, it's goodbye, and see you again next time.
Good day today. Tell us about it from your perspective. There was quite a lot of contact today, wasn't there? Would you say things between you and your rival got a bit heated today? Well, thanks anyway.
Well, let's hope for a better race next time out, eh?
Aby se mi nezvolali ty poslední upgradey u oddělení pohonu by Adonka šasí ještě pošetřím, ale nemělo by to selhat. Snížil by to 4%. Do Británie by měl být hotový a tady. Když je první trénink pojedu s takhle opotřebeným spalovacím motorem. Tady je provodovka a uvidíme, jestli se ten upgrade povedl nebo ne. A shodou okolností se něco takhle podobné stalo i ve druhé sezóně, kdy jsem ještě zavěděl za Williams. A mimochodem právě tady v Silverstoneu.
We had a major issue on the production line earlier this week, so the entire development package for this weekend has failed. Check your workstation for the details.
Děláš si prdel! Naše si už to má zlevněný. Měl to být šance na úspěch jenom 4,50. Jen 4 poslední šance, že se to zmrví. A přece jen se to zmrvilo. Do Německa už to bude 100%. Já si říkám, že jsi se měl utratit na tohle. Tahle máme to nejlepší auto. Ferrari nás to dotáhlo. Vidíte ten trend. Zavřu tady v první sezóně, to jsem ještě závodil za Williams. My jsme hodně odepsali, ale zlepšovali jsme se. Soustředili jsme se ještě na spolehlivost, kterou jsme dotáhli na max. Tady byl Williams dokonce výkonnější než Sauber. A od roku jsme se tady už závodil za McLaren. Neměl to auto vůbec spolehlivý. Kterou jsem začal s výkonnostníma upgradeama. A teď už patří McLaren zase mezi tu špičku. Tak já děkuji, že jste dívali. Sorry, že tady kecám tak dlouho, ale... Radši už nasledanou.